The next new feature we're going to talk about is another add-on. So I'll click on my add-on tab and I'm going to look at the smart blocks. When you click on smart blocks, you will see all these different smart blocks pop up. So I'm just going to demo them all for you here. So I'll give you an addition, you get a subtraction, and they all work very much the same. Multiplication, division. I've got some power blocks. What else do we have here? Square root. And my favorite, the unknown block. Okay, so that is all the blocks. Now all you have to do is write some numbers. Make sure you separate them a bit when you're writing them so that they don't think that it is the same number. Or, like the number 19, if I had written those two close together, zero, and maybe I'll make a six over here. Okay, now all you need to do to make a smart block work is connect it to another. To the block. So I draw a line from the 0 to the addition block and the 4 to the addition block. And now I have 4 plus 0 equals, or sorry, 0 plus 4 equals 4. Let's try the subtraction. 6 and 1 is, let's try that again. Let's try a different number. Maybe it doesn't like my 1 for some reason. It's 5. You can erase these, so I could get my eraser. Oops, my eraser. And I could erase these right here, and I could draw another one. So let's try this one. Now lost its other number. So let's say 6, and let's do take away 9. Let's see if it'll do negative numbers. And it does. So that's great. Okay, this last one is sort of interesting here. If I do this 5, and I attach it to the mystery block. And the 2, what it does, if you give it a second, is it says 5 something 2 equals 2.5. So what is this equation here? So is it 5 multiplied by 2 is 2.5? 5 plus 2 is 2.5? You have to figure out what the equate or what they are doing here, what the operation is. Another thing to note when you're doing these, if you go on to the next page here, you can actually use pictures as well. So if I grabbed the, say, the addition block, I'll put the addition block on here. If I decided to group some of these, so I've got like, say, three Mona Lisas, and I'm going to group them together. Group them together, and oh, and I'm going to group my four Mona Lisas together. So group those together. I've got four Mona Lisas and I've got three Mona Lisas. So if I had three Mona Lisas in this basket and four Mona Lisas in this basket, how many Mona Lisas do I have altogether? Same thing. I can use my pen. I can drag them. So that's three and four, and now I've got seven Mona Lisas. So you can use images as well. Now, one thing to be careful of is if I were to, I'm going to erase these connectors. If I were to take these two items right here and group them together, okay, so there's three here and there's four here. If I highlighted those items and then I were to group them together, it will only count them as two items. So now watch what happens. When I draw it in, it shows me that I only have two. So be careful of that when you're trying to use items and you're grouping things. But that's how the magic blocks work.